you're finding ways for kids to get what they need and to remove barriers so that they're getting what they need so they can reach their potential.
Our vision in special programs is that we are supporting all students, highlighting their strengths and trying to help them build independence, right? So how do we provide and grow that environment for our students? And so inclusive practices really is a step towards that.
We go into teaching because we care so much about children. We really want them to be successful. And I think inclusive practices is that just backbone to every kid gets what they need to be successful and feel successful, but also working as a team of teachers and a team across the campus.
Once you're there, you're just like, this is amazing. You know, you get to collaborate with other schools. You get to hear presentations from other people. You could spend more time with your own team.
Being able to go to the Inclusive Practices Academy, it was great just to bring it all together, coming from that teaching background and now into the team leader position. Just the importance of having those kids served in the classroom, just like every other kid in the building.
They broke it down into, just try this. How about this? Partner with a teacher and just try it in one subject area. You know, start small. And I really appreciated that. And I want to do all the things, but it was really great that they gave us these ideas and they gave us a chance to collaborate and to really learn how to speak to each other.
The roles, the teacher role, the SPED teacher role, the IA role. And I think that was a big takeaway because it gives a clear understanding of how everyone is impacting these students and what their job is.
We were really able to learn different models for presenting and working in collaboration with other teachers for all of the students.
It's not just an overnight process. Like in the summer, we can't just say these two teachers are co-teaching together this year. It's a process. They've got to get to know each other. They've got to get to know how each other work so that they can best serve kids.
I think it comes back to the heart of the campus. What does the campus desire as far as inclusivity?
It is our job as classroom teachers to deliver that instruction also. Reflect on that practice and think, what do I need? What do I see in our systems that's not allowing me to do that? What do I need? Because teachers are amazing. And we've got to get that information to them and listen to them so that we can create these inclusive environments.
It's just-in-time learning, and you're able to take what they talked about and turn and use it in your classroom or apply it immediately, which is, I think, what we're always looking for. It takes some of those big ideas and puts it in a smaller chunk for us to chew on and then go and practice and then come back and reflect on what we just tried and talk about again. Did it go well? Did it not?
It's important that all kids feel included in their environment. It's important that they have access to high expectations as well as getting their socio-emotional needs met. So keep that as your focus and your fire.
We're giving them the tools to do what we know is good and right, right? So every student deserves a good quality education.
To be a leader and to watch not just kids grow, but also adults grow. And in the end, everybody's working for the same passion on your campus and for kids.